Hey everybody, Vanessa Bartlett here with you today. Now we're going to do some shoulder strengthening exercises with a TheraBand. I've had a lot of requests recently to train and strengthen the deep shoulders. It's really important to have deep muscular strength first as your foundation before you start doing heavier movements like full body stuff, you know, push-ups, planks, burpees, heavy weightlifting, things like that. Really, really important that those deep shoulders can stabilize you first, and of course, switching on your core. So we've got a TheraBand. Now, if you want to get a TheraBand, there's many different brands out there. I recommend if you're starting out with deep shoulder strengthening, you get a light to a medium one. There's normally three or four colors with each brand. So just, get a couple of different colors depending on your strength level. And then you can work your way up to a stronger resistance. So the first exercise we're gonna do, I've got a medium band today, by the way. First exercise we're gonna do is for rotator cuff, which is a few muscles deep in the shoulder there, which are responsible for the rotation of the shoulder joint as well. So we've got our feet together. We've got our hands shoulder distance apart on the band. Pull your shoulders down and back to begin with. Okay, so it's important that you don't work from a slumped position, because then you're all out of whack to begin with and you're going to strengthen the wrong muscles. So we want to pull our shoulders down and back, draw our tummy muscles in. We have the hands shoulder distance apart and we pull the band sideways, keeping our elbows tucked into the ribs. Breathing in, breathing out. So I'll just turn side on so you can see that the elbows are in fact in contact with the ribs. Okay, they're not coming out to the sides. Breathing in, breathing out. Let's do 10 more together here. Inhale, exhale. You don't have to open the band too wide to feel it. It's quite an intense exercise when your shoulders and your elbows are in the right spot. And six more. Five, four, and three. Keep the chest lifted. And two, one. And the next exercise we're gonna do is gonna strengthen the top part of your back. So for this one, I want your shoulder blades again to draw down and in. These two bones here, drawing down and in through your back. So posture in the setup of these exercises is really important. So we're gonna take our feet to hip distance apart. We're gonna stretch the band out to the sides. So the palms are upwards, our shoulders are down and back. We breathe in, we open the band to the point where you're feeling your shoulder blades in your back kind of pull down and in. So I want you to pull your shoulders down and back in order to do that, and slowly return the band to the center. Breathe in and breathe out. Now turn side on for this one as well. Breathing in and breathing out. So with this exercise, notice that I'm not just pulling the band back and bringing it back to my chest. If you're doing that, you're using the wrong part of your shoulder. You don't want to strain the actual deltoid itself. We want to be strengthening down in here. So just facing my back to you for a moment, opening to there. So it's about three quarters of the way to the sides. Breathing in, breathing out. Down and in through the shoulder blades. Should really feel that start to work. It's also quite a strong exercise and nice to help tone your back at the same time as getting your muscles around the shoulder blades a lot stronger. This is also a really good one for posture. So if you tend to slouch, or if you do a lot of forward work on a computer, these side extensions are great to train your upper back and really lift. Let's do a few more. And three, two, and one. Next thing we're going to do is a bicep curl with the TheraBand. So there's a couple of different angles that you can take on this. So today I'm showing you using the TheraBand, just being able to hold it yourself. There are other variations of doing it on a doorway or tying it to something secure on the wall. But for now, we're just going to be supporting the band ourselves. So I'm standing on the band with both feet. Let's move back a bit so you can see. Now you want to pull your shoulders down and back again, draw in through your tummy muscles. Open your chest and we squeeze the band up and slowly down. So the great thing about doing a bicep curl with the TheraBand is that you get the resistance on the way down. So what we call that is an eccentric muscle contraction, but you don't have to worry about that. Concentric up, eccentric down, which means the muscle is working on the way up and also on the way down. You can really feel that tension there. And it's supportive on the shoulder too. It's not like a heavy weight, for instance, where it's weighing you down. You can still hold your posture nice and strong and centered. So let's do 6 more bicep curls. What I want you to take care of here is to not just let it go and the band just drops. Okay, you're still working that muscle eccentrically. Let's do 4 more and 3, squeeze it up. 2 and 1, good. Let's change sides. So having enough tension in the band to begin with is important. If you're holding it too high up and you start moving and dropping it like that, that's what's gonna happen. Or you wanna make sure that it's not too loose at the same time, otherwise this is no tension in the muscle at all. So pull it down, try not to let it flick you in the head, and squeeze up and down. Up, so just enough tension to feel the muscle contract on the way up and also have to work on the way down. And it's not a big drama if you breathe in as you come up or if you breathe out. Just try and match one breath with one movement, whatever's best for you. There's arguments on both of that. Okay, so some people will say breathe out on the lift. Some people say, no, you've got to breathe in on the lift. I think whatever works best in the situation for you. The most important thing is that you're activating this muscle on the way up and the way down and keeping your posture nice and aligned. 4 more. And 3, 2, and 1. Good. Next one we're going to do is a diagonal extension. So you can have your feet hip distance apart, pulling the shoulders down and back. That's always your setup. Let's take the band forward again. The palms are up. This time we're going to stretch the band on a diagonal line and then back to the center. So one arm goes up to the side while the other one pulls down. This is going to target the back of the shoulders and also around that shoulder blade area again. So in this little workout, we're targeting your back and your shoulder because it's all connected anyway. Even if you have a shoulder injury, you really need to make sure that your chest is being stretched, which we'll do in a sec, and your upper back is being strengthened to help keep everything in the right place. Let's do 4 more. And 3, really keep the band reaching forward rather than towards you. So that way, you should feel it in that upper back. 2 and 1. It's always quite strong to do that. Let's do 10 the other side. 1, back to center, and 2, and 3, 4, good, 5, 6, 7. Don't be surprised as well if you feel a little imbalance from one side to the other. 9 and 10. Great. Standing on the band now with both feet, hold right at the ends of it, and then we're going to stretch our neck to the side. Keep your shoulders down and back, draw your tummy in. It's always nice to finish with a neck stretch with these. And then head to the other side. Good. I'm going to give you one more exercise just as a little bonus here because I know we like to tone the strength in the triceps. Now this is a good little exercise as well to open your chest. So whenever you've got your arms back, you're actually opening your posture, which is great. So again, we want to draw our tummy in, make sure the ribs aren't flaring out, pull them down, but stay tall and long in the spine at the same time. We've got one hand at our lower back holding the TheraBand and the other hand just behind our head. So in that case, your elbow has to be quite close to your head. Okay, so let's stretch it up for 10 and 9. The bottom hand stays steady. 8, 7 and 6. Really getting that tricep strong now, which also helps support the arm and shoulder. 4, 3, good, and 2. And 1, and let's change sides. It's easy just if you can flick it over, swap the other hand onto the lower back. bring the other hand behind the head and start to stretch up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Keep the elbow close to the ear. 5, 4, and 3, 2, 1, and bring it down. I want to show you one more exercise to help strengthen the upper back even more and train those shoulders to be down and back in healthy posture. So I'm just going to duck over here to the bar so that you can see. So we've got the bar, the band wrapped around the bar, okay? So the hands are on either end. I'm just going to have my back to you to show you this one. Feet hip distance apart. Draw your shoulders down and back and then pull down and back. Down and back. With this one, it's really important that your abdominals stay strong, okay? And you're not rotating forward into your posture. You keep your posture down, shoulders down and back, and posture strong. Draw those shoulder blades together the whole time. Let's do 6 more, and 5. Keep pressing the arms down, and 4, 3, 2, good, and 1. Great. Hope those exercises really helped you today. Post a comment below, let me know what other workouts you would like to do or muscle groups you need to target, and I will film a video for you. And please subscribe to the channel, share the video if you feel it's of benefit to other people as well, and I will see you soon. Bye.